So in last lecture, we have seen that what are the conditions for setting off overflow flag, and under what condition overflow flag will remain reset, and same about for carry flag. Now in today's lecture, we will see few examples of means how overflow flag and carry flag are going to set or reset. With certain examples, we will see that. Now, let us assume that first we will see the signed operation. Suppose there is one number -125, and there is another number. Suppose this is -5. So I want to add these two numbers. Basically, I want to perform -125 plus -5. I want to perform this operation, and the result in this case will be -130. So -130 we cannot represent by 8-bit binary number. So in this case, overflow flag shall set. So we will see this. How we will represent -125? So we know that -128 is represented by 80H, -127 by 81H, -126 by 82H, and -125 by 83H. So -125 we represent by 83H. So this is 83H. Or you can also calculate this. How to calculate this? Just first, just ignore the minus sign. Find the 8-bit binary value to represent the magnitude 125. So for this, if we write, then it is in this way: D7, D6, D5, D4, D3, D2, D1, D0. So it in D7 is having weight 128, and this is having 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and 64. So 125. 125 means here it is 0. 64 plus 32 is 96, plus 16 is 112, plus 8 is 120, plus 4. Is 124 plus 1, 125. So this. Now you just convert this number in 2's complement. For that, first you will write the 1's complement. This is 1000000010, and 2's complement. In this, you add 1. So if we add 1, then this will become 1 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 1. This, so -125 we represent by this. And what is this? This is 8 and this is 3. So same way we have written here 3. So we will write the binary of this also: 1 0 0 0 0 0 1 1. Now how we represent -5? So now to represent -5, again we will write first we will just ignore this minus sign, and we will write the 8-bit binary value to represent this 5. So this is 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1. Now convert it into first one's complement. It is 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 0. This is 1, this is 0. Now 2's complement. In 2's complement, simply add 1. So here it will become 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Yes. So this number is F. So this is F. And this is 8, 2, 10, and 1, 11. 11 means B. F, B. This. So, and just to confirm this, we already know that minus 1 we represent by FF, minus 2 by FE, minus 3 by FD, minus 4 by FC, and minus 5 we represent by FD. So it is same, FD. So now you write the binary of this 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1. Okay. These are the number. Minus 125 is this and minus 5 is this. And we are going to basically add these two numbers. So we perform the addition. This is bit number D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, and D7. So 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 1, carry 1. So 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 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 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 0, and 1 carry is generated. And 1 carry is generated here. Now, as an 8 bit, we are having this number. What is the magnitude of this number? What this number represent? This number is, we find the magnitude of this, here it is 128, this is 64, 64 plus 32 is 96, 96 plus 16 is 112, 112 and 8 is 120, plus 4 is 124, plus 2 is 126. So this number represents 124, and since here it is 0, D7 bit is 0, so this is plus. So basically, when we are performing addition of 83H and FB, that is minus 125 and minus 5, then we are getting this result, which represent it is plus 124, and this is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because the actual result should be minus 130. And minus 130 is beyond the storing capacity of this 8 bit. Because with the 8 bit we can represent minus 128, maximum this. Beyond this we cannot represent. We cannot represent minus 129. We cannot represent minus 130. So that's why this result is wrong. And after performing this addition, since we are performing the operation, signed operation, that's why we shall check our overflow flag. If overflow flag is set, this indicates that whatever is there, 8 bit, this is wrong. What is the condition for overflow flag to set? First condition, either carry generated from D6 and no carry from D7, overflow flag will set. Or no carry from D6 and carry from D7, overflow flag will set. So during this operation we have seen this, when we are adding this particular bit position 0 plus 1, at that time no carry is generated. But when we are adding D7 bit position, carry is generated. So there is no carry at D6 and carry at D7. Under this condition, our overflow flag is set. So if we just monitor the overflow flag, then immediately by seeing this one, we can conclude that whatever is there in this 8 bit, that is not correct. That is not correct. Now if we consider these numbers as unsigned number. What is the number? Number is 1000011. This is first number, and second number is 1111. If suppose these are our unsigned numbers. So for the unsigned number, this number represents 128 plus 2, 130 plus 1, 131. This number represents 131, and the second number, it represents 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1, and this is 251. So this is 251. So if we add these two numbers, so again we will find the result is 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 0 with carry flag 1. So this is 8 bit. Now what is the magnitude of this? Magnitude of this is 64 plus 32 is 96, plus 16 112, plus 8 120, plus 4 124, plus 2 126. So this is 126. Hence we are adding 131 with 251, and in the 8 bit we are getting 126, which is again wrong. So if we simply monitor the carry flag, if carry flag is 1, this indicates that the unsigned addition is not correct, right? So if we are considering the numbers as a signed number, in that case we have to check overflow flag, otherwise we have to check carry flag. We will see one another example. Suppose 1 minus 125 and with this we want to or we can say 126 plus 126, in this you have to add plus 2. Suppose this is the operation. Now in this case, plus 126 is represented by seven E H. So this is 0111 and E is 1110. This is 126. You can just calculate this, this weight is 64 64 plus 32, 96 plus 12 is 96 plus 16 is 112 plus 8, 120 plus this is 64 plus 32, 96, 96 plus 16 is 112 plus 8, 120 plus 4. 124 plus 2, 126. And since here it is 0, this indicates the number is positive. Now plus 2 we represent by 0 to h. So this is 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, 1, 0. If we add these two numbers, so 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 plus 0, 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. And 1 plus 0 is 1. So now here, this is the result, and what is the status of overflow flag? For overflow flag, we have to check this bit position. This is D6 and this is D7. When we are adding these two bits, one carry is generated. One carry is generated here, and when we are adding these bit position, no carry is generated. So carry generated when we are adding D6 and when no carry generated when we are adding D7. This means overflow flag should be 1. So overflow flag is 1. This overflow flag 1 indicates that whatever is there, this result is not correct. Because what is there? This is 1000001. So here this 1, it indicates that this is a negative number. This one, because we are considering the signed number, so here this one indicates this is a negative number, and the number is 80H, and we know that 80H represents minus 128. So when we are adding plus 126 with plus 2, and we are getting result minus 128, which is wrong. So this will be indicated by overflow flag. Because plus 126 plus 2, it is basically plus 128. But we cannot represent plus 128 in 8 bit. Because the maximum positive number which we can represent by signed 8 bit number, that is plus 127. Beyond this, if any result is coming, that we cannot represent. That's why we are unable to represent plus 128. When we are adding, we are getting 80H, which indicates it is a minus 128. So this indicates the result is wrong. But whereas, if we will see same numbers for the unsigned operation, 126 in signed number will represent it by 7EH. 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. And 2 we represent 02H. This is 0000010. You add this. So again, when we will add, then we will get here 1000, 1000 and 0000. And in this case, carry flag is 0. So if carry flag is 0, then this indicates whatever is there, that is correct. Because you now just see, number is 1000000. So you just find out the magnitude of these 8 bit for unsigned number. Then we find that the magnitude is 128. Because what is the weight for this one? It is 128. Remaining places we are having 0. So this number represents 128, which is correct, because 126 plus 2 is 128. So numbers are same. It is 7e and 02. Here it is 7e and 02. But as a programmer, suppose I am programmer A, I am considering these numbers as a signed number. So after the addition, I will check only overflow flag. Just by seeing overflow flag, I conclude that whatever is the result, this result is wrong. Now there is programmer B. Now programmer B is considering these numbers as an unsigned number. After the addition, programmer B will check only carry flag. And when he will check carry flag, then he finds that here it is 0. So this 0 indicates that whatever is the result, it is correct. So for programmer B, after the addition, whatever result is coming, that is correct result for him. For programmer A, whatever result is coming after the addition, for him it is wrong. This means processor, after the addition, it will generate overflow flag and carry flag both. Now it depends upon a programmer whether he will consider the overflow flag and overlook carry flag, or he is considering the carry flag or overlooking the overflow flag. So accordingly he will interpret the result. But as a processor, it will same number, it will consider signed also and unsigned also, and accordingly it will generate the overflow flag also and carry flag also. So now it depends upon us how we interpret the result. So now same example, we will just see in MCU 8051 software also, okay, how exactly things are happening for this. So now we will just see how overflow flag and carry flag will be affected. So just now we have seen one example where we were adding plus 126 with plus 2, and the result, in the result overflow flag will be 1, because plus 126 plus 2 is 128 and we cannot represent plus 128. And at the same time, when we are considering these numbers as a unsigned number, then 126 plus 2 will give you 128, which is the correct result, and in that case carry flag will remain 0 because the result is correct. So we will find this particular example. So we will write one program here. So our first instruction, you will write ORG 0000, because this indicates that our first byte of our program is at memory location 0000x. Now I will write one instruction, add. Or before add, what I will do? Move A comma hash 7EH. Now with this instruction, what I am doing? Plus 126 is represented by 7E. So this number, first number, I am sending to A register, that is accumulator register. After this, I am using one instruction, add. So regarding this instruction, we will discuss later on. But just you understand, this instruction is used to add two numbers. And out of two numbers, one number must be in A register. That's why before add, I have written move A comma hash 7E. By this, first number I have just taken to A register, and now add A comma hash 02X. So this instruction will add 02 with the value of A. In A already we have loaded 7E. So now 7E will be added with 02. And finally, whatever is the result, that will be stored in A itself. So this is a small program. And in the last, I will stop this H1, comma, SJMP H1. This is the label and end. So I will save this and I will compile this. Okay, now before just coming to this addition, you see this is our numbers. This is 7E, first number, 1 plus 126. It is 0111, which is 7, and 1110, which is E. Then plus 2, 0000, 0010. So now when I will add these numbers, so in that case, you just see here, 0 plus 0 will be 0. Then this 1 plus 1 will be 0 and one carry will be generated here. Now this 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and one carry will be generated here. And this 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and one carry is generated. Now this 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and one carry is generated here. This 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and one carry is generated. This is carry. Now 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and one carry is generated here. And 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1. So you just concentrate at this position, bit number D3. When we are adding this bit position, at this bit position, finally one carry is generated. See, this is one carry. It's generated after addition at this bit position. So as we discussed that, if a carry, this is the lower level, if carry is generated from D3 bit position, then auxiliary carry flag will be 1. So here we find that AC flag will be 1. Regarding carry flag means final carry. Whether final carry is generated? No. Carry flag will remain 0. Then overflow flag means overflow flag, while adding this to bit position, one carry is generated, right? 1 plus 1 plus 0 is 0 and carry is generated. This is one carry, and 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1, no carry from D7. So if carry is generated from D6 and no carry from D7, then overflow flag will set, overflow flag will be 1, okay? And what about the parity flag? We already know that parity flag means whatever are these 8 bit values, this 0000001, we have to count the number of 1s, and number of 1s here are 1 only, which is an odd number. So if it is odd number, so parity flag will also 1. So we have to just monitor this. Actually carry flag is 1, carry flag is 0, overflow flag is 1, and parity flag is 1. This also we will verify now. Okay. So now this is the first instruction. In the first instruction, 7E, see the green color line,
7E is a data, we will move to A register. A register you can find here, this is A register. Here currently it is 00. So at this point, 7E will come. So I will execute this. You just observe here. Now it is 7E. Now this green line has come to the second instruction. This will add A comma 02. So now 02 will be added with A. In A we already have 7E. So after the addition, the result will be 80. And that result we will find in A. So after the execution of this instruction, in A you will find 80. And depending upon this result, you will find carry flag 0. So it will remain red. Auxiliary carry will set. So AC will become green. And overflow flag will also set. It will also one green. The LP flag will also become green. So we will see this. Now I am going to execute. And you see here 80 will come. See, now 80 is here. And see, carry flag is 0. Here, red color. AC flag has become green. This indicate it has been set. Carry flag is reset 0. Auxiliary carry is set. And now this is the position of overflow flag, OV. It has become green. This means this its value is 1. And in the last P, parity flag, this also is green. It indicates it has been set. So in this way, after the addition, carry flag and overflow flag both will generate some value. Now it depends upon us whether we shall consider overflow flag or we shall consider carry flag. Okay, so now in this, just one thing I want to show you. We discussed about the special function registers. So you can find the special function register here. This is special function register. This. So, zoom kar dete hain. Yahan. Ye jo hai na, ye box. Is box ko zoom kar dete. So this is the special function register you find here. See this register. Here it is B, register B. And its address is this, F0 is its address. After this is A register. And its address is E0H. And this is your PSW. And its address is D0H. In last lecture we discussed some addresses. PSW its address is D0H. And this is IP register. Interrupt priority register. It controls with this we can just change the priority of the interrupt. Its address is B8. After this you can find this is port 3. Port 3 address is B0. Then this is IE register. Interrupt enable register. With this we can set the interrupt. And its address is A8. Then after this is SCOM register. It is used for serial communication. Its address is 98. After this is port 1, P1. Its address is 90. And this is PCON register. PCON is used for timers. And its address is 88H. After this P0. This is P0. Its address is 80. And this is T-mode register. T-mode register, and you can find this is TL0 register, then TL1 register, DPS, data pointer register is a 16-bit register which we can split in 2 8-bit register. So this is DPL, lower 8 bits of data pointer, DPH, higher 8 bits of the data pointer. This is TH0 for timer. TH1 for timer, PCON. So these are various special function registers which are available and their addresses.